first, in our Sanatana Dharma, Hinduism, they clarify some fundamental principles. When I said principles, it's called tattvam. Tattvam means things which are in its intrinsic, natural, fundamental state. Tattva. The closest, if you want, as a simile is element. You know, there are a lot of compounds. And when you take the compounds off, you say these are the elements. And these are the fundamental elements in which all these compounds, millions and zillions of compounds, are made of in this world. And now I don't know the number. It used to be 108, and now they have made it to 140, 150, I think. And we say these are all the elements. So anything in this world, any material, you can actually split it and say that 1, 2, 3, 4 or many of these fundamental elements only compose that. But if you go a little more deeper into it, then we go to the particle level. Then they say there are 3 particles. Now I don't know how many are there. But when I read physics, basically we talked about 3 fundamental particles. Maybe it is 6 now, I don't know. And they say there is something called negative charged electrons. And then there are protons and neutrons in the nucleus. And now there is all antiparticle on all the other stuff there. And when they go even into the subatomic particles, they talk about 6 types of fundamental particles in which the entire universe is made of. Now we have boiled down the universe to some 6 fundamental principles. Na? So that's what is called tattvam. Likewise, our Sanatana Dharmas also thus have done a wonderful investigation on what are these fundamental principles, tattva, which existence is made of as we know it, physical existence. The beauty with the scientific approach of our Sanatana Dharma, which is slightly different from the West, at least till 50, 60 years back, is it not only included that which is observed as the universe into its fundamental principles, it also included observer and that which aids the observation in defining fundamental principles, right? And for example, if all matter is made up of 5 fundamental elements as per Sanatana Dharma, either it is made of earth, or it has some element of water in it, it has some element of air in it, it has some element of fire in it, it has some element of space in it. Now, what it really means is, anything which is observed is what is the basis for science now. And most of the scientific facts are done with merely 2 sense organs, which is eyes and ears, you see. So that which you see and hear is what most of the science is made of. But our rishis said, why nature has given us 5 sense organs? Na? So the fundamental matter should also be classified into 5. That which is seen. So that which gives us this vision, the object which we see, and then there is something which we taste. And so there is an agency of tasting, there is an agency of feeling, there is an agency of seeing and hearing. So when we have 5 sources of knowledge, when we look around in this universe, our Sanatana Dharma said, then since science is based on facts, facts are nothing but truth distilled through these 5 sense organs, observations. So matter is also classified as 5, you see. And what are those 5? We have that which creates a sense of taste, which can be observed by our tongue. And that is what we call as water, or that fundamental element which contributes to taste of things, you see. Fundamental element which contributes to smell of things is earth. The fundamental element which contributes to the touch, feel, very sharp, blunt, smooth, rough, etc. That is what is called air. So when I say air, it's not just this atmosphere. Eh? Air means an element which contributes to touch. And then that which contributes to our vision, color, form, etc., is what we call as fire, agni. And that which contributes to sound is called akasham, or space. Right? So the earth, the final element, has all the five. The water has four. Four means that we can touch it, we can taste it, we can see it, and of course there is sound also in water, right? And then it keeps on reducing. And in space, there is no smell, there is no taste, there is no sense of touch, and there is no sight, but there is only a sound which can pass through space, you see. So these are how we classified external objects. But we didn't stop there.